Okay, in this video, we're going to continue looking at GitHub Copilot. Now we're going to round up all of the different functions and even the object-oriented class we made here from our previous videos, and we're going to ask Copilot to help us create some testing functions. This is a standard feature of software development, having to create test cases to ensure that what you've created works the way that it should, and Copilot can really help us out here. So let's see what we can do with this, and we're going to take two approaches. We'll use some comments to serve as prompts to ask Copilot to create the test cases, and also just create some function definitions and see if it can autocomplete these for us. So this is similar to what we've done in our previous videos, using prompts and relying on autocomplete. Let's get started with our Fibonacci function. And let's begin by simply creating, I think in this case, we'll use a prompt by writing a comment. So let's write the following. Create a test case function for the Fibonacci function. Let's say include 5 test cases, use assert statements. That's a good idea. I like the autocomplete suggestion there. And let's see what it does with that. So it has begun by giving us a function definition, which we can accept. It's fairly standard practice to put test as the start of a test function definition here. So we have test underscore Fibonacci, so we can understand this is linked to our Fibonacci function. We'll tab to accept that, then we'll uncomment that, because obviously we want to keep that. Then let's see what it does next when we go to the next line, see if it auto-completes this for us. So now we have 5 test cases. This looks great. We're checking for the value of 0, 1, 2, 5, and 10. This looks good, so I'm going to tab to accept those. So we are checking whether these return the correct value. Ah, we've got an underline here. Let me just uncomment out this function. So of course, we're testing it. Okay, great. We're using this test function that the Copilot created for us. What I think I'll do is I'll add an extra test case in here. Let's add a failing test case. It's always good to ensure that your function is working both passing and failing tests. Now we're expecting 55 for a value of 10. Let's change this to 56 and see if this last one actually throws an error because it shouldn't pass. Okay, I like this. This is a great function. Let's save this. And let's run this test function now, test Fibonacci. Save this, and then let's run this file and see what happens. We expect that the first 5 test cases will pass, so there should be nothing returned. But this should return an error because we're asserting that the Fibonacci sequence number for the value of 10 is 56, when it should in fact be 55. Okay, let's run this now and see what happens. And here we go, we're running the file, and we can see that everything passed apart from the last one, and you can see in the traceback here, assert Fibonacci value of 10 equals 56, assertion error. And that's what we expected. This should be a failing test. So everything is working exactly as we wanted it to. Great. We've now created our first test case function by using Copilot. Let's now move on to the object-oriented class that we created and create a test case for that. So I'm going to comment this out as well, because I'm not using this at the moment. Sometimes when you've got multiple different things active in your file and you're trying to create test functions, Copilot can get confused, so I actually like to comment these things out when I'm doing this stage here, just to ensure that Copilot knows what I want to do. So here, I'm going to come beneath this class, and instead of writing out prompt via comment, I'm simply going to write the beginning of my test case function. I'm going to create the function definition and see if Copilot can fill in the rest for me. Let's uncomment this so it knows that it exists. Fantastic. And let's create our function here, and let's call this test person. See, I'm following the same convention. Now let's go to the next line and see what it does for us. What have we got here? Brilliant. Okay, what have we got? Excellent. This looks good. So it is creating an instance of the person object. It is adding a job. It is asserting that the job is equal to that which we've added. We are then trying to add another job. And if you recall, in our previous video, we set up this logic here with the help of using Copilot to refactor the function to say that if we already have a job, we're not going to reassign it, and we'll print out that we already have a job. So when we're trying to add a job of data scientist when we're already a software engineer, we should see this print statement. And then with this assert case here, we're going to assert whether the person's job is equal to software engineer. This should return true. What I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to data scientist to show, or in fact, let's have both. We have the passing and the failing. So we're going to say, there we go. So what we're doing is we're creating our person instance. We're adding the job of software engineer. We're asserting that that is in fact the job assigned to that instance of a person object. We're then trying to add the data scientist job. This should throw out this print statement because we already have a job. We're then asserting that the job is still equal to software engineer, should also return true. and then we're going to assert whether the job had been changed to data scientist. This should throw an error because this should have been caught here, prevented from happening. So let's save this and let's run this test case. So we're going to go to the next line, call our test person function, save, and we're going to run this now. I'm just going to clear this down here just to make it a little bit neater for when we're watching what's going on. And let's run this now, see what we get. Okay, so let's take a look at what we've got at the console and try and make sense of what's going on here. So to begin with, we can see that when we've tried to add the job of data scientist, we've got this print statement saying that John already has a job. This is what we expected because this is what will happen in this method here. Next up, we can see we've got an assertion error when we try to assert that the person's job is equal to data scientist. This is what we've done with this deliberately failing test case here. As we know, we tried to add the job of data scientist. We had the print statement saying he already has a job. So this is why this failed, because we could not assign a new job to our person object as it is currently set up. Obviously, in the real world, people can change jobs. This is just an example of seeing that what we are doing here is working properly. And when we try to use our test case, it is backing up that our method is doing the correct thing for our current design. Excellent. So this is another excellent test case that we created with Copilot. Everything seems to be working well. Great. And in this instance, rather than using a comment as a prompt describing what we want to do, we simply created our function definition and let Copilot intuit or anticipate what we want to do by creating the code for us. And in this instance, the code looked good, so we carried on by using it. Of course, this is a very simple test scenario, but you can see the power of using it to help you create your test cases. Okay, let's move on to our other functions that we created in this series so far. I'm going to comment all of this out, and I'm going to move down and see what we've got next. So the next functions we created were our encryption and decryption functions, our CSER, cipher, encrypt, and decrypt. Let's start with our encrypt function. I'm going to uncomment that, and I'm going to again try and create a test case. But in this instance, once more, I'm going to just create the function definition and let Copilot try and fill in the gaps. Now we've created two test cases. It should have got some idea of the context of what we're trying to do. We used the comment to begin with, and we used autocomplete for the second test case. In this case, we'll continue to rely on autocomplete. Maybe we can also consider using comments to refactor if we don't like the look of the test case. Let's see what happens. Let's begin by creating this function, test CSER, and see if it comes up with an idea for autocomplete. Yep, great. So I didn't have to write the rest of this out. You see how I paused for a moment? I started to write test CSER. I was going to write the rest of cipher encrypt. This already anticipated what I want to do, and it's also created a range of test cases here to see whether they work. So I actually like the look of this. I'm going to tab accept, then have a look through and ensure that everything is in line with what I would want to do for testing this function. Now, in this instance, the one thing that you can see, which is a little bit strange, it has created five test cases, all doing exactly the same thing. Now, from what I can tell, there's no real benefit to doing this. So I could easily just delete these four. So as you can see, you cannot just rely on Copilot to know what to do exactly. It's giving you some help, but it's not always going to come up with the most intelligent solution. Having five identical test cases makes zero sense. Why would I test the same thing five times? Obviously, it'll be very fast, but why waste the resources in doing so? Let's delete those test cases and see if we can come up with something else. And you can see that suggestions are still the same. So how about we create something different? I'm going to write this out. I'm going to call that function, and I'm going to pass in a different string. And the string I'm going to pass in is simply hello hacker. And I'm going to put it as, look, now we are getting some extra help. I hadn't even finished this. I can tab across and you can see that it has created what it thinks is the correct value for this. So it has been able to intuit what I want to do, but I had to get it started by writing something different out. Because at the beginning, it was just writing the same test case five times. I think this really helps to underline the fact that Copilot is a great assistant, but you still need to have your own programming knowledge and expertise to understand whether what it's doing is helpful or not, or whether it's what you want to achieve or not. Now we've got two test cases. We'll just stick to three for this one. I'm going to copy this one. I'm simply going to come down here and I'm going to change one character of this. And as this is what we're expected to come out, this should in fact be a failing test case. So we can save this and then run this test function and see if we get two passes and a fail. I'm going to save that now. I'm going to come down here and clear the dialog just so it's a bit cleaner. And then I'm going to call this function. Okay, so we're going to move down here. Let's call our test. There we go. It wants to fill it in for us. It already knows that we've written this function. We probably want to call it. So it's automatically giving us a great autocomplete suggestion. Really helpful. Let's now save and run this file and see what we get. Console. And as we can see, we have an assertion error for our last test because we are asserting something that we know is actually going to be false. So everything seems to be working again. These are passing. This is failing. And everything looks to be in order. So I think you can follow along quite clearly with what we're doing now. So let's comment this out. Do the same again for our decrypt function. Just carry on with the rest of this file just to make sure that works okay. Let's uncomment that code. Let's come down here and let's begin writing our test. Let's see. Automatically knows what we want to do. See, it's being intelligent. It's anticipating our needs now. It's got three different test cases here. It's basically doing the inverse of what we just did up here. You see, it's using the encrypted strings as the inputs for our decrypt function and seeing whether or not they all come out to be true or false. So we're doing basically the same test but in reverse by using our decrypt, and we're expecting two to pass and one to fail. Let's save this, call this function. Again, it knows we want to call it. Great. And let's run this, and we should see a error down here, an assertion error, when this last one fails. So we'll run this now. At the bottom, there we go. We get an assertion error for the last one. Everything seems to be what we would expect. So once more, this is getting quite good anticipating what we want to do because we're doing something similar on each occasion. Okay, let's now comment this out and try and wrap this up by looking at our isPalindrome function. And this will conclude our looking at using Copilot for generating test cases. Okay, so let's comment all of this out. Let's move on down to our final function, which is our nice little isPalindrome checker function. And let's now create one final test function for this and see if Copilot can help us out. So isPalindrome, and now we are checking five different tests. That all looks fine. Let's accept this for now and review what we have here. So first of all, we're checking whether or not this string race car is equal to true. This looks like a palindrome to me. Similarly, we've got the capitalized version, but if you recall, we were putting all of our text to lower in this function, so this should also return true. That's fine too. The reason this wouldn't work if we didn't put the text to lower is because the capital R and the lowercase r do not have the same UTF code points. This would in fact return false if we didn't put it all to lower. Next, we have a situation where we have an exclamation mark at the end. This is intriguing. We're asserting whether or not this will return true. This should in fact return false, so this should return an error. After that, we have the same test, but we are saying this will be false. Now, this would in fact pass, but because this is likely to fail, we're never actually going to get to this test, which is an interesting idea. Maybe we should switch this one around to ensure that we can get through our passing tests, then get to our failing test. And finally, test number 5 seems to be the same as test number 3 now, which is weird. So once again, Copilot is doing its best, but it's come up with another test which isn't very helpful. Maybe we could change this and just remove a character and say that should return false. Now, this will, of course, also be a passing test, but we're not going to get to it because this is going to fail. Maybe we'll remove this one from position 5, put it to position 4. Now we have 5 tests. 4 will pass, 1 will fail, and the last one is the failing one. So we should get through all of our tests before we get an error, an insertion error for that failing test. Let's save this now, and then let's run this test to wrap up looking at using Copilot to generate test cases for us. It's anticipating what we want. It's already saying you want to run this, don't you? I'm saying yes, I do. So I'm going to accept that suggestion. I'm going to clear the dialogue just to make it a bit neater for us. Another final thing is simply to save and run this file and see what we get. Console. So let's run this now. And what do we get? There we go. We get an assertion error when we tried to check whether race car with an exclamation mark returns true. As I already pointed out, this is clearly not a palindrome. There isn't an exclamation mark at the start. If we had an exclamation point here, we'd be fine, but we do not. Therefore, this is a failing test, and everything seems to be working exactly as we wanted it to. So there we go. This wraps up our look at using Copilot for generating test cases. As you've probably been able to tell, this is a very simple example of how we're using Copilot to help us generate test cases. We're just looking at simple assert statements. Of course, when it comes to testing, and when you get into more professional development, you might be using test-driven development, you might be using unit test, PyTest, other modules, and the type of testing you'll be doing will be far more complex than what I'm doing here. But what you can see is by using this example and this introduction to using Copilot for testing, that it can help you create test cases. Some are good, some are not so good, but it's a great place to get started. And once you've started to create your own test cases, and Copilot is able to analyze the context of what you've written, you may find it can generate even more helpful and more comprehensive test cases for you, give you better code coverage, etc., etc. But the point I'm trying to make here is that by using Copilot, you can certainly enhance and potentially speed up the testing process for yourself. This can be particularly helpful if you have boilerplate style test cases that you are using in your code, because Copilot can analyze and assess this, realize that's what you're using, and try and use it as a model for creating other test functions for you, which can again speed up your testing coding, which is sometimes a good thing, because depending on how you feel about testing, testing is an essential part of development, but it can also be quite time consuming and maybe less fun for some people than actually doing the real coding itself. Great. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Join me in the next one where we'll be looking at the Copilot chat beta and seeing how we can use this, interact with a large language model a lot like ChatGPT, and we'll be seeing how we can interact with this to try and help us with our coding as well. I hope to see you there.